Hey there, it's me, Sophie. So in today's educational vlog, we are going to talk about communication breakdown. But first, let us define what communication is. Communication is a two-way process by means of sharing and transferring ideas, information, thoughts, and emotions from one person to another. This connects people and builds harmonious relationships. Have you ever been misunderstood by someone? Perhaps a miscommunication like this?
Excuse me? Beh, can you tell me where I can like eat noodles here? Is it left or right? Noodles. Yes. Ah, jjajangmyeon. I can understand you. So meh.
This scenario exemplifies communication breakdown, wherein there is a failure in communication between the two parties due to some barriers present. Now, let's discuss the four categories of communication barriers that causes communication breakdown. In communication, we have what we call physical barriers, a natural or environmental condition that acts as a communication barrier in the transmission of a message from sender to receiver.
Girl, where are you now?
I'm on my way now.
Yeah.
Hello.
What? Hello, what?
I said I'm on my way now.
Para po. I can't clearly hear you. Late ka na naman.
Gosh, stress me out.
In this example, the person one can clearly hear what the other person is saying because of the noise from its surroundings. This is why physical barriers cause communication breakdowns.
Miss De La Cruz? Miss De La Cruz, oh anak, it's time for you to recite your speech na.
Yes po ma'am.
Pero naman ako, diba? Kaya ko to, tuwala lang.
I'm here in front, please.
Una reporter ba? Lasi.
Basta you'll have to treat me later, ha?
Ah, go Precious, you can do it.
Mukha siya kinakabahan.
Uy, krasyo, mag-report na.
Class, be quiet. Go on, anak.
Good morning, ma'am, everyone. Today, I will be reciting my speech. The environment, the earth.
Oh, Precious!
Kakapag-recite pa kaya siya?
Hala, natulala na si ate girl.
The earth.
Tulog mo naman yun, oh.
At least, kabota ka.
La, kabalang yun, sis. You can do it.
This is an example of psychological issues. These are mental barriers that refer to social and personal issues of a speaker towards communicating with others. This may be due to trauma, shyness, lack of confidence, anxiety, depression, or stage fright. These strong emotions make it difficult for an individual to communicate effectively with others. Another barrier to communication that may cause communication breakdown are what we call cultural barriers. These are encountered by people regarding their own personal values, beliefs, and traditions which are in conflict with others. They may have different races, religion, age, or gender. Because of that, it may negatively affect the way they communicate and relate to one another. Lastly, we have linguistic barriers. This pertains to words and delivery of statements that have different meanings, especially in different places. Hence, they may cause confusion and misunderstanding among communicators. Differences in language are also linguistic barriers.
Ni hao ma!
How are you?
Kumusta ka?
Genki desu ka? Even though they all mean the same thing, we won't be able to understand and respond effectively if we don't know these languages. Physical, psychological, cultural, and linguistic are the four categories of communication barriers. However, Verdever gave the same idea of barrier when he classified noise into three kinds: external, internal, and semantic noise. External noises are sight, sound, and other stimuli that draw people's attention away from intended meaning, like this. Therefore, external noises are physical barriers. Next, we have internal noises. This pertains to thoughts and feelings that interfere with the meaning, like this. Basically, internal noises are psychological and cultural barriers. Lastly, we have semantic noises. This means that a word may have another meaning in others' minds, like the use of jargon, incorrect grammar, and idiomatic expressions. This barrier may cause misunderstanding between and among communicators, much like linguistic barrier. Those are the different barriers to communication that causes communication breakdown. Remember that it is important to recognize these barriers to communicate effectively and avoid communication breakdowns. Once again, I am Sophie, and this ends our episode about communication breakdown. Don't forget to hit the like, subscribe, and notification bell for more updates. See you in the next one!